Hi there, thanks for tuning into Dear Cyber Sue. Today I have a question from Barry. Barry says, I'm dating a girl who says she doesn't want a relationship and she's very adamant about it. She said it a few times, but she's kind of contradicting herself because she wants to see me all the time. And I mean lots. So why is she doing this? Why is she sending me these sort of mixed signals? Barry, a lot of times when people don't know what they want, they do send out this convoluted message. So they're actually telling you the truth, but sometimes they don't really know what it is and why they don't think they should be in a relationship. Sometimes they just got some demons and cobwebs stuck in there from a past relationship or something they haven't dealt with in their life, and they're afraid, they're scared. Majority of the time when people are very adamant, I don't want to be in a relationship, they're not over something. They're still dealing with something that's happened to them. So if they're telling you that, believe them. And even if she wants to see you every day, you make up your own rules. She's told you she doesn't want a commitment. If you want a commitment and you're okay seeing her under these conditions, then keep doing so. But the fact that you're writing me tells me that you're not okay with this and you want more. So you're kind of in the friend zone, you're kind of in the booty call zone, and you're kind of in maybe a relationship down the road zone, and you're sitting here thinking, you know, I can hang in here for a little while because I really like her. She's pretty cool. If somebody's telling you they're not ready for something, listen to what they say. I'm not saying you have to say goodbye to her, but don't see her all the time. Don't just sit there and be at her beck and call whenever she wants to see you. Say, no, I've got things going on. No, I can't do this. Maybe she just needs to have some time between her last relationship and meeting you. Whatever the case is, you're not there to fix her. You're not there to make everything okay and better for her. You want to be her guy. You want to be somebody that she can turn to and say, you know, I really love you and I'm committed to you. Right now she can't do that. You don't want to be a guinea pig or the stepping stone here either. So make sure you're not just her soft place to fall right now. You want to be something that could be consistent down the road with her. And I appreciate the fact that you're giving her a chance and you think that there's just some stuff she needs to work on. We can always make those mistakes for very long periods of time in our life where we think, oh, just maybe another 6 months and she'll be fine or he'll be fine. If somebody is really adamantly telling you they're not ready for a commitment, you really should hear them out on it. So see her once in a while. Don't give up other stuff. If she's not ready for a commitment, you're free to date. I know a lot of women will kill me for saying that, but you are free to date because she's not ready for commitment. So see her once in a while, see if maybe she changes her tune, but I wouldn't hang in there for another 2 or 3 years if she keeps saying the same thing to you. Because it doesn't matter what sex you are, if somebody's telling you that you're dating, they don't want a commitment, and they're seeing you all the time, there's something that needs to be worked on here. Something needs to change. And you don't want to sit there and be the last person to figure out that they really meant what they said in the beginning. So pay attention, listen to what they say, and make it work for you. If you want to see her once in a while, see her once in a while. But don't see her every single time she calls or arrives at your front porch. Have some boundaries for yourself, because she's definitely got hers. So don't sit there and just take what she has left to give you, or if she wants to see you, boom, 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 and you're always there for her. Stand up for yourself. Thanks for writing, Barry. And thanks everyone for tuning into Dear Cyber Sue and my new subscribers. You're awesome. And thanks for liking and commenting on the video. Thanks everyone. Bye.